Hello, dear students. I hope you all are safe and sound during this difficult time. Okay, so we are going to start our online classes for class 7th students, science. So we are going to start with chapter 1, that is nutrition in plants. Before we start our chapter, you need to know what all are the contents which are given or which we are going to study in the following chapter. So first of all, we will start with the introduction of the chapter. Finally, then mode of nutrition in plants. What are the different type of modes which are used by the plants to obtain nutrition? Next is the photosynthesis, the definition, the process, all the things which are related to photosynthesis will be studied here. Now, synthesis of other plant food other than glucose. Next is other modes of nutrition in plants other than autotrophic mode of nutrition or photosynthesis. What different modes are being used by plants to obtain nutrition? Next, the nutrients which are being depleted from the soil, they are again replenished. So how these nutrients are replenished in the soil? And finally, I will give you a concept map to understand the basic idea of total chapter. Okay. So now, starting with this introduction, as we know, all the living organisms in this world require food. So food is essential for all living organisms, whether they are animals or plants or human beings, fungus, etc. So why do we need food? What is the essential thing about this food? See, all we know that the food is most important thing which we take to obtain energy. Without food, we will not be able to do any work since we don't be having any type of energy to do work. Next, with the help of these materials or nutrients which we obtain, they are essential for our growth. So without the nutrients which we obtain from the food, our body will not have proper growth. Okay. Other than growth, the damaged parts of our body, the damaged tissues, cells, and the things which are being worn out, they also require energy to be get repaired. Okay. And finally, we also need nutrients to carry out different life processes. So what are life processes? All the processes which is done by the living organisms to sustain life are known as life processes. For example, respiration, transportation, nutrition, etc. All these are known as life processes. So we all require food for all these functions. For what are they? To obtain energy, to obtain materials for growth, to repair the damaged parts of the body, and to carry out different life processes. Okay, so what are the main nutrients which we obtain from the food? You have already studied that one in class 6. They are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, and minerals. So these are the most essential components of food which we need for all the things which you have already studied. And these components are known as nutrients. Okay. So, what is the basic difference between plants and animals and human beings? Plants are capable of making their own food. Okay. They can make the food by themselves. But humans and animals, we can't prepare food by ourselves. Okay. So, depending on this type of nutrition or mode of nutrition, there are the mode of nutrition in plants is being divided into two types. First of it is known as autotrophic nutrition, and the second one is known as heterotrophic nutrition. Okay, so before starting this mode of nutrition, we must know what is nutrition. So the process of utilization of food by living organisms to obtain energy is called nutrition. Whatever the food which we all are eating, that is being utilized in our body to obtain energy for the different life processes. This process or this phenomena is known as nutrition. Okay, so there are two modes of nutrition as shown in the figure. First one is autotrophic and the second one is heterotrophic. H-E-T-E-R-O-T-R-O-P-H-I-C. Okay, so this is the two modes of nutrition in plants. So that we are going to describe that nutrition in detail. First one is autotrophic nutrition. So auto, as we know, auto means self, and tropos means nourishment or nutrition. So whenever the nourishment or the nutrition is provided by the self, it is known as autotrophic nutrition. So obviously we know plants are the only one that can provide nutrition to themselves. They are the only one they can produce food by for themselves. Okay, so only plants which are having chlorophyll are coming under this category. So how do these plants, they sustain autotrophic nutrition? So what does they do? They have chlorophyll. Okay, the green pigment in the plants is known as chlorophyll, and this chlorophyll is having a special property of capturing or trapping the solar energy or the energy from the sun, and by the help of this energy they are preparing their own food. And for this process, they are also requiring carbon dioxide, water, and this both these things. They are preparing their own food. Okay. So this type of nutrition in which the organisms are able to prepare their own food are known as autotrophic nutrition, and such organisms are known as autotrophs. So now you have understood that only all green plants are autotrophs, because rest all who are not having chlorophyll, they can't prepare their own food. Okay, so that is why only green plants are called as autotrophs, and they prepare their food by the help of a special process that is known as photosynthesis. That process we will be studying in detail. Okay, so since they can produce food, all the green plants are known as producers. So coming on second type of nutrition, that is heterotrophic nutrition. Okay, so heterotrophic nutritions or heterotrophs, they are organisms who obtain food from other organisms. Okay, these organisms, they are depending on other organisms. As the word indicate, heteros means other, and tropic, we know that it means nourishment or nutrition. So organisms that get nourishment or nutrition from other organisms, or they depend on other organisms for their food, they all are known as heterotrophs. So all the organisms other than green plants come under this category. In this category, we include this human beings, animals and fungus, etc., because we all are dependent on the green plants to obtain food. Okay, so organisms that follow the heterotrophic mode of nutrition are known as heterotrophs. So one thing may came into your mind, that since our mothers, they are also preparing food for us, so are they autotrophs? You can say, no, my mother is preparing food, so they are also, she is also a autotroph. No, your mother is cooking food for you by the help of the materials which she get from the plants. For example, she used wheat to prepare chapatis, and potatoes and other vegetables to prepare curries. Okay, so only the organisms which can capture the sunlight and can produce food are known as autotrophs. Okay, so next we are going to deal with the process photosynthesis. So photo means light, and synthesis means to make. So in detail, how we can define photosynthesis? It is the process by which green plants make their own food. And what is the food which is made by green plant? That is glucose. By which plants make their own food from water, carbon dioxide, in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, is known as photosynthesis. Okay, so presence of two things is very necessary for the photosynthesis, that is sunlight and chlorophyll. In the absence of any one, plants can't do the process of photosynthesis, and that is the reason photosynthesis could be only done during daytime. They can't perform it during night. Okay, and see, two simple substances which is very essential for this process are water, which the plants they get from the roots, and the carbon dioxide which they get from the atmosphere. And as you can see in the figure, the leaves, they are green because of the presence of chlorophyll. They obtain light energy or solar energy from the sun. They obtain carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and they obtain water and minerals from the ground with the help of roots. So by this process, they can do photosynthesis. And during photosynthesis, what two things happen? First, the most important thing, production of glucose. So glucose is the food for the plants. By using carbon dioxide and water, they produce glucose. And second, oxygen is released during photosynthesis. So oxygen is the byproduct of photosynthesis. That is why it is said that we must plant many trees so that more and more amount of oxygen should be produced, and that is why plantation is very necessary. Okay. Now about photosynthesis, you must know some important points about this photosynthesis. So certain points are, the first one, the process of photosynthesis only takes place in the green leaves of the plant or the parts which are green or which contain chlorophyll. Since the green leaves are the main place where the plants prepare their food, that is why the leaves are known as kitchen of the plant. So where do your mother prepare the food? She prepares food in the kitchen. And that is why the place where the green plants prepare their food, that is green leaves, they are known as kitchen of the plant. Now, what is the food of the plant? It is a simple sugar, which is known as glucose, or the simplest carbohydrate, that is glucose. Okay, so the plant prepares food in the form of the simplest carbohydrate or a simple sugar, which is known as glucose. And when the more amount of glucose is being prepared by the plant, they store this glucose for future use. Okay, but this glucose is stored in the form of starch. So starch is nothing but a long chain of glucose. So many glucose molecules are joined together to form starch, and this starch is leaves of the plant. Okay, so the food which is prepared by the leaves is known as glucose, and the stored food of the plant is the starch. Now, during this process, which is known as photosynthesis, what happens? The green plants, the leaves, the chlorophyll, it captures the solar energy or the light energy given by the sun and convert it into the chemical energy in the form of this glucose. So what is the conversion of energy? Solar energy into chemical energy. And you can see here the chemical equation or the reaction which takes place during photosynthesis. Here what happens? With the help of carbon dioxide and water, plants prepare glucose and release oxygen. This process happens only in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. So both these things are very essential for the process to carry out. Photosynthesis will not take place in the dark or during night, since the plant will not get any sunlight. Okay, so CO2 is the chemical formula for carbon dioxide. H2O, you know it is water, and the chemical formula for glucose is C6H12O6, that is carbon 6, hydrogen 12, and oxygen 6. And finally, our very own oxygen, that is O2. Okay, so this is certain important points about this photosynthesis. Now you must know that photosynthesis, it takes place in three steps. First, as usual, the capture or the absorption of solar energy by chlorophyll. Next one is the conversion of light energy into chemical energy. And finally, the production of carbohydrate, that is our glucose. Okay, so the process takes place in these three simple steps. Next, we must know, we have already studied the four components which are essential for the photosynthesis. Number one is chlorophyll. It is a green pigment which is present in leaves. Okay, and this is the only chemical which captures the solar energy. Finally, they need carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. They need water from this, they absorb water from ground with the help of their roots and the solar energy. In the following diagram, you can easily see the cross section of a leaf. So when we see this leaf, when we cut a small piece of leaf and see it under or observe it under microscope, you can see certain openings there. Okay, the cells are arranged, the plant cells are arranged in a sequence and which contains the green color pigment called chlorophyll. But in the last row, you can see a small opening which is present, okay, between two cells, and these two cells are known as guard cells, and the small opening which is present is known as stomatal opening. So what is stomata? Stomatas are the openings which are present on the surface of the leaves by which the carbon dioxide is being absorbed by the plant, and the two cells which guard the opening or which are responsible for the opening and closing of stomata are known as guard cells. Okay, so this is the basic structure of the stomata. You will be dealing it after in the next class. Okay, and the structure of stomata is very essential and it is very important for the plants, since through this opening, the carbon dioxide which is present in the atmosphere will enter into the plant cell, and by which the plant cells are able to carry out photosynthesis. Okay, now to understand the importance of this sunlight, we have slowly we will be dealing with each and every component of the photosynthesis. First of all, we will be dealing with this sunlight. Okay, so in this activity 1.1, you will come to know that sunlight is very important for the formation of glucose or starch. Without sunlight, the plants will not be able to do photosynthesis. So for this experiment, what you have to do? You have to take two potted green plants of same kind, okay, same type, and the one plant, it is kept in the sunlight, and the second plant, you have to keep that second plant in dark or in the absence of sunlight for at least 72 hours. So why we are keeping this for 72 hours? So that all the stored starch in the green leaves of that plant would be used up by the plant. So after 72 hours, there will be no starch left in the leaves, and since they are not getting sunlight, the plant will not able to produce more glucose. Okay, so after 72 hours, the plant will not be having any starch, and it will not have any type of glucose. Okay, and after the 72 hours, you have to pluck leaves of both the plants, and you have to perform iodine test on both the leaves. So this iodine test, you have studied that one in class 6. When we are applying iodine drops on starch, or when the iodine is reacting with this starch, what happens? The color becomes blue-black. Okay, so we are plucking the leaves of both the plants and we are performing the test. So after this, what happens when you're performing this test? A second step, you have you will be recording your results. So we will be discussing after some time what will be the result. After this test, you have to take the plant which was earlier kept in the dark. You have to take that plant and again you have to keep it in the sunlight for 3 to 4 days. Okay, so after that, you can see see the change, and you have, by performing the iodine test again. Okay, so what all are the observations which you are recording in this activity? What happens in the first activity when you are testing both the leaves? What happens? The leaf of the plant which was kept in the dark will not turn blue. Okay, while the leaf of the plant which was in the sunlight, it will turn blue with iodine. Why it is so? Because there were no starch left in the plant which was kept in the dark. But the plant which was in the sunlight has already have this starch. So it the leaf will turn blue. Okay. So after keeping this plant which was kept in the dark, when you're keeping it in the sunlight for 3 to 4 days, it will produce obviously starch, and finally when you're testing it again with the iodine, now it will also produce blue color with the iodine. Okay, so by this activity we can explain that plants prepare their food from the carbon dioxide and water in the presence of only sunlight. And when we keep the plant in the dark, it will not be able to make starch, and finally the results are negative. Okay. So, and it after keeping it in the sunlight, what happens? The iodine solution, it turns blue, the leaf, because the plant is able to produce starch in the presence of sunlight. So this is the basic activity which explains the importance of sunlight for the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so that's all for today, students, and here is the assignment which you have to do in your homework copy. The first one is define the terms nutrition, autotrophs, heterotrophs, photosynthesis. Second is you have to draw a well-labeled diagram of stomata. Third one, write the complete chemical equation for photosynthesis. And finally, write the components which are necessary for the photosynthesis. So this assignment you have to do in your homework copy. That's all for today. Stay tuned. Thank you. So stay safe, stay home. Okay. Thank you.